Well, hello everybody. This is Pastor Dana. I am so glad that you have joined me today. Maybe you're listening to this first thing in the morning as a part of your devotions. Maybe, you know, with all of us being quarantined, maybe you have the whole family gathered around and doing a devotion together. But we're going to be bringing you during this week a devotion every morning, Monday through Friday, just as we approach the Easter season. And I am so thankful that you are here with me. It is so important that during this time of uncertainty, when so many things are changing in our life, that we take time to know who we are, to know whose we are, and to know what belongs to us in Christ, to keep our minds and our hearts turned toward God, turned toward Savior, and let's celebrate Easter fully. We need to experience His resurrection power in the days that we're living in right now. So listen, I'm glad you're with me. And let me begin today. I want to begin today by reading a passage from the Gospel of Luke about the Last Supper and just share with you a couple of thoughts that are on my heart as we get into this Easter season. But I'm going to read Luke 22, starting with verse 14, and I'm actually going to be reading it out of God's Word translation. It says, "When it was time to eat the Passover meal, Jesus and the apostles were at the table. Jesus said to them, 'I've had a deep desire to eat this Passover with you before I suffer. I can guarantee that I won't eat it again until it finds its fulfillment in the kingdom of God.' Then he took a cup and spoke a prayer of thanksgiving. He said, 'Take this and share it. I can guarantee that from now on I won't drink this wine until the kingdom of God comes.' Then Jesus took bread and spoke a prayer of thanksgiving. He broke the bread, gave it to them, and said, 'This is my body, which is given up for you. Do this to remember me.' When supper was over, he did the same thing with the cup. He said, 'This cup that is poured out for you is the new promise made with my blood.'" You know, I'm always amazed as I read the Last Supper that Jesus makes the statement in this particular translation. It says that he was, let me make sure I get this right here, go back to this. It says that Jesus said, "I have a deep desire to eat this Passover meal with you before I suffer." And I just stop and I think about that. I think about that he knew why he had come to the earth. He knew that he had come to die for us. He knew that that was going to include a lot of suffering. And yet, he said to those sitting at the Last Supper, he said, "I've desired to eat this meal with you." Perhaps his greatest desire was that he wanted them to look back and reflect on that so that they would really grasp what he had done and grasp the sacrifice, that then looking back on the Last Supper, these disciples and all of us would recognize that it was his body that was broken and given for us, that it was his blood that he shed for us. And that as we thought about his broken body, as we thought about his sacrifice, as we thought about his blood that was shed for us, that we would begin to understand what all that affords us. Listen, his sacrifice wasn't for nothing. As we approach Easter, as we think about this Last Supper, can we all just be thankful for all that belongs to us? You think about the broken body of Christ. Not only did it provide the forgiveness of our sins and restore the broken relationship between God and us, but his body was broken so that we could be healed. His blood, there is power in the blood of Jesus to free us and to protect us from every plague. Can I just encourage you today to just sit and take a moment, breathe deep, and think about that Last Supper. Think about the sacrifice of Christ, his body that was broken for you, his blood that was shed for you. And right now, here today, what that means for us. We're doing life a little bit differently, but the power of his sacrifice is no different in this situation and in this circumstance. So today, as you think about the Last Supper, I want you to, by faith, just receive what you need today, whether it's healing, whether it's protection, whether it's forgiveness. Jesus gave his all so that you and I could have all that we need. Listen, I love you, and we'll come back tomorrow with another devotion, but I just want to close this out with a prayer for you today. Can I do that? Can I pray over you and your family today? Father, we just continue to believe for your strength, for your presence, for your goodness poured out on us and our families during this season. As we approach the Easter and the celebration of the resurrection of our Lord, we thank you for all that his sacrifice provided us. Freedom from sin, freedom from sickness and disease, protection and blessing in our life. And Lord, I speak those things over the people today, and I speak them over them in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, God bless you, and we will see you again tomorrow.